Yes, Rishi Sunak is in Washington. He's there, of course, to meet the US President Joe Biden. He wants to forge a closer economic alliance. Well, I'm joined down the line from Washington, D.C. by Nile Gardiner, former aide to Margaret Thatcher and director of the Margaret Thatcher Centre for Freedom at the Heritage Foundation. Nile, it's great to have you today. You guys have been trying to take Prince Harry. He's been in court here, but you've been taking him to task in America because you want to see what he said on his visa form. How are you getting on with the American legal process?
Well, Nigel, thanks very much for having me on the show today. It's great to see you. And as you mentioned, we have basically taken the Department of Homeland Security in the United States to federal court to release the immigration records of Prince Harry. We believe there's a strong public interest in the release of those records, especially in light of Harry's admission of widespread illegal drug use in his book Spare. And so we want to establish whether or not Harry was honest in terms of his application and also whether he was given any preferential treatment. There was a court hearing yesterday in the District of Columbia Federal Court presided over by a federal judge. He has ordered the Department of Homeland Security to issue a decision by Tuesday next week on whether or not they will release the records. If they do not release the records, then there will likely be further hearings. And ultimately, a federal judge will decide on whether or not those records will be released. But I think a very positive hearing yesterday. We're fighting to win this this legal case. We're fighting to hold the Biden administration to account here and calling for transparency and accountability.
Yeah. OK, it'll be very interesting to see what the outcome of it is, and a very big initiative from the Heritage Foundation. Now, Rishi Sunak has gone to meet what I think is perhaps the most anti-British US president in many, many years to talk about forging a close economic alliance. But in the absence of a free trade agreement, which the Biden administration seems hell-bent on not doing, is, on the economics of this, Rishi frankly wasting his time?
Well, it's actually emerged, I think, over the last hour or so here in Washington that Rishi Sunak is not going to be pushing the issue of a US-UK trade deal. And that is in large part because Joe Biden's been very hostile towards Britain. As you say, I mean, he has been, I think, the most anti-British US president of modern times here. Biden is no friend of Great Britain. He has treated Britain in an appalling fashion. Biden is anti-Brexit. He's pro-EU. He is a sneering and arrogant left-wing president, actually, who has undermined the US-UK special relationship. I do think, though, it's a huge shame that Sunak is not pushing forward, actually, with a US-UK trade deal, because many members of Congress, many US senators, fully support a trade deal with the United Kingdom. Rishi Sunak should be standing up to Joe Biden. He shouldn't be demonstrating any sign of weakness. He shouldn't be kowtowing to the Biden White House here. The Prime Minister should be standing up for Britain on the world stage. It's in Britain's interest to have a trade deal with the United States. There's tremendous support in the US Congress. Sunak should raise the issue, but
I agree.
According to reports here, he's dropped the idea.